Asia United Bank has a new business solution for MSMEs who want to be able to accept credit card payments without the costly requirements of keeping a terminal. How? Well, let's ask our first guest, Mag Certida of Asia United Bank. Mags, good morning. Welcome back to Market Edge.
Hi, Michelle. Nice to be back here.
All right. So, Mags, I want you to walk us through very quickly how this new QR link works and what makes it different. What's the competitive edge?
Okay, we developed this so that our MSMEs can actually accept Visa, MasterCard by using the AUB Payment Unified Card QR Link. Mm-hmm. Because in the past, well, today, if they want to have a POS terminal, they need to meet the minimum transaction volume per month. And if not, they have to pay a fixed fee. So this one removes that headache. They don't have to worry about how much transaction volume they have every month. And they can accept any Visa, MasterCard, credit, debit, and prepaid cards.
Mm-hmm. I guess the number one question for consumers would be the time it will take to complete a transaction. I mean, compared to using a terminal, you swipe and sign. Sometimes you don't even have to sign. You're done. In this case, yeah. I will have to scan a QR code. That code leads me to your website where I need to manually input my credit card details. Did you do a time study to determine how much time it will take for me to actually start and end that transaction?
Of course, the transaction authorization time in the POS terminal is really seamless and immediate. Mm-hmm. But the MSMEs don't have the high turnover volume the same way the large merchants have. Mm-hmm. So this one is will take a few minutes because you have to input your card number, your CVV, and your expiry. And some would require you to do the OTP. Mm-hmm. But in essence, if you have less than the number of transactions required a month, meaning you have a low volume transactions, 1 to 4 transactions a day, then that would suit this type of operations.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. All right. I'm very curious though, when you look at your competitors, this space, PayPal, for example, has something similar, although it's a payment link, not a QR code link, where you don't even need to have an account with them to pay, but they charge around 6%. Of their transaction. Mm-hmm. How competitive are your rates?
Well, we have about less than 3% for this kind of transaction. Okay. So yes, PayPal is a bit pricey. So here we just deploy a card QR link for their merchants and they can do they can actually do in-store transactions. They can actually do out-of-store transactions because from our AUB payment app, they can generate either a fixed QR code or a dynamic QR code with an amount. Mm-hmm. So if they want to entertain off-hours transactions outside their operating hours, they can also do that.
Ah, all right, interesting. I'm also looking at, you know, several other banks, a Malaysian-based bank with a presence here. A few years ago also deployed, you know, a gadget that they attached to a merchant smartphone that enables them to swipe without volume requirements. I mean, and then you look at your telco giants that are e-wallet operators, they also offered this swipe service 8 years ago, I recall. Why now? Don't you think you're sort of late in the game? And what's the edge here?
That's true, but there's still a cost attached to that because after all, it's still a gadget. So there's still a cap, even if how minimal it is. So here, we don't really think about that. We just want to deploy as many terminals, as many QR card QR link out there. Because remember, we're targeting MSMEs. So there are what, 90% of the over a million establishments that we have today are under micro, over 100,000 or close to 100,000 are under small enterprises. So we just need to deploy it easily, fast, without too much hassle. Because remember, today these merchants are almost familiar with how a QR transaction works. Here we don't have to deploy somebody to teach them how to deploy a terminal, put it on, or transact. We just deploy a card QR code and we train them the same way we train them when they accept QR transactions. So it's basically fast, seamless, providing them the secure transaction authorization that they need to have.
All right. Do you consider this, though, an uphill battle? Trying to gain market share from, I mean, you're looking at a dozen other players, including giants with who enjoy first mover advantage. Is it going to be an uphill battle? I mean, how big is the market that you're looking at? Because I imagine you're going after, you know, MSMEs and as merchant partners and Filipinos with credit cards, but no e-wallets yet. I mean, what is the, how big is the ocean for you? Is it still a blue ocean?
Okay. I think it's a blue ocean. Mm-hmm. In the sense that, of course, you've had so many acquirers now for so many years, And look how many card terminals we have in the country. Not even close to over 200,000. But there's over a million market out there that we want to tap. So this one is really, though the market is huge, we want to act fast. So this is our way of doing that. We've piloted this last year, and we think that we've targeted the right market spot on because they don't really meet the required transaction volume of the other acquirers deploying card POS terminals. So I think we will succeed here because it's the space where we've always wanted to do. It's the space where there's a much needed service, or it's really an untapped segment.
So what are the KPIs? You have KPI targets, I imagine, since I know that you did a pilot in January. What are the results and where are you so far?
So we've deployed about 7,000 card QR links. Mm. So our finding is right on the spot because an average transaction of an MSE merchant today with at least mix of them, 10% will actually be over 300,000, but 90% of them are will transact about 65,000 pesos every month. So that's about 1 to 2 transaction counts a day. So this is the kind of market that you want to go after. They're small, but there's a lot of them. So, I mean, even if like a next player would come in, the market is huge, we can share that pie with them.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. All right. And what sort of contribution are you expecting this to generate for Asia United Bank? Of course, this is the banking arm of the Robisco Group. What kind of contributions are you looking at?
Well, what's good about this is that every day we receive merchant applications, and we realize that 40% of our merchant applications every day are really qualified to have this kind of product. So what that means is that there's an instant upselling right away. And the bottom line is that we are able to generate more transaction volume per merchant every month. So I guess, and after that, of course, we start to sell our other bank products.
Mm-hmm. Well, the future is digital and you guys are there. Thank you so much, Mags, for joining us and for sharing this new feature that you have for MSMEs. Thank you very much and have a good week.
Thank you, Michelle.
Congratulations.